Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats immediately. The show is about to begin.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Paraclaw Gaming. I'm Officer Parrot, OP. Today, we are playing some Firewatch. I'm thinking where we are in the game. I'm probably just going to finish it today, however long that takes me. So let's just get right into it. Let me unmute the audio because it's really loud in my ear. I'm using backup headphones because my other headphones died because I was editing so much. You're welcome. All right, let's do that. And we'll get into some Firewatch. I forget if my remote works. Yes, it does. All right. I don't even remember where we are. I think, we just finished Wapiti Station. Follow the receiver. Yep. And that's the... I forget the name of that. That fire. I forgot what we named it. Nope. Ah, there we go. Let's go. I put this game down for a while, and then I started watching Markiplier play it. And, had a very, very good, concept of the game. Very good, I don't know how to say it. Very good, rationale, I guess you could say. But, like I said, I played this game once before through the whole thing. I don't remember what it was, what the ending was. Clearing in the bush. Clear the bush. I don't know why I backed up. Oh, I see it. That's how you do it.
D, I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine, but there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Also true. Oh.
Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
Back to the tower! I don't know how. Zoom? Where am I? Can't even see myself on here. Alright, oh, there I am. So I gotta go west. West. Alright. Oh, there's a light. Alright. So I've been working on, with the lovely assistance of, Captain Beaver, I have been working on a new intro, a new outro, and just better quality videos. Just being able to, like, I edited the.
Hey, I got turned around. Is that person still there?
No, he's gone.
I'll call you when I get back.
Jonesy. Two Forks, that way. The accident video, I did a lot of editing in that, because, I got turned around in the game. And, but it's coming along. I will succeed one way or another. And hopefully you're here to watch it. Where is my... There is the burning... Where's my tower? I should be able to see my tower from anywhere. Oh, I see it. I have to check on Turt Reynolds. One thing I have to check. Because of Markiplier. No, I think Bernie's in the, in the room up there. Alright. Bernie!
I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
Left a cassette player taped to my damn door.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Well, let's see what's on it.
Not good.
Down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
That's freaking out. It's not good. What else ain't good? Rewinding and listening to something over and over and over again. Isn't that the definition of insane?
So your little bender isn't looking like such a good idea under the light of a new day, huh?
No, it isn't, but that's not it. Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Take my Pulaski. Oh, wait! The flapjack fire. No, wait. Wait. Biggest thing of all. Turt. You come with me, buddy. Yeah, you better come with me. Camera? Ugh, come on. Zoom. We gotta go north. Which way is north? Ah, I really haven't been keeping up with this, this lookout. Gotta go north. Alright. This is all coming back to me.
Hey, you didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
I don't even know how to call anyone other than you. And please, rest assured, I would have found someone with a better sense of humor a long time ago.
Okay. Thanks.
Yep, here it is. Four, five, two.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave. Is this thing working? Delilah, send someone to the cave, please! Getting damn reception.
Looks like we're going this way. Use Pulaski. Make the Pulaski Skyway! Squeeze through. How skinny is Henry? Alright. Jump.
It's freezing in here.
Well, it's a cold cave. I'm sure it would be. Shoe is not a good sign. Weird. Oh yeah, I have a flashlight. Right about that. Hello.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Well... North? We'll go north.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
Brian Goodwin. The Draculords.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
What, you're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge. I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
Well, that wait's over, sweetheart.
Call me sweetheart again, and you'll use that big sexy brain of yours to fill out your unemployment paperwork.
Sorry, boss.
I think these two, like, canoodle over the phone. Over the radio.
Whatever. A bunch of rocks stacked up, you made a wall and a perimeter.
That's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied. And just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear. His anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. It sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him. You know, tinkering on... stuff like that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. Say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
Well, this just is a little base. Hey. Hi.
He made the place pretty comfy, too.
That's an achievement.
Yeah, at the expense of what are probably stolen pillows.
That little shit.
Oh, I want to take a picture. I forgot. Now climb down. Climb down.
Gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Yes. Old outhouse, old cabin, there it is. Now, if memory serves me, there is a surprise in the fireplace. Oh. Yep, there it is. And I got an achievement. Nothing? Okay. Alright. Back to what I'm doing. Deeper into the cave. Will I go back to the cave now? I think?
Got a dead elk out here. It's torn up something good.
You think it got wise to a government program?
Shut up. This elk is wearing a tracking collar. The wave receiver picked it up.
Is that right?
Yeah, it's numbered.
Makes sense.
Maybe they were tracking elk at that site. Maybe they were doing exactly what they said they were. Delilah.
Yeah.
There was lots of equipment there. I mean, they could have been up to a lot, you know?
Yeah, sure.
They could be.
She's not buying it. I'm not buying it. He's just trying to reassure himself.
Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, we've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
South is... Alright, going the right way. Over. Gets me back into the cave. Yep. Now we go explore. Oh. All right, I vaguely remember what happens, but not 100% sure. I did not finish Markiplier's playthrough. Pretty much watched up until Wapiti Station and then stopped because I didn't want to spoil mine. My playthrough. On drop. Alright. There you go. No. Down here. Yep, I remember this. Yep. That's where the shoe's up there. I remember when I first played that was a hard scene to get through. It's almost like the Red Dead Redemption ending. You don't see it coming, and then when you figure out what's going on, you're just don't know what to do. Plain and simple. Huh? that closes behind me? I guess I'll climb out. Give Delia the wrong... Delia? What? Give her the news.
Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How
nope.
Is that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. Delilah, you should have told someone he was out here.
Just stop.
Oh.
Okay, I know.
Maybe he would have...
Henry, you insensitive shit. You don't think I know he'd be alive if it weren't for me? And I fucking know it's my fault. I'll never forget that it's on me.
I didn't mean to pick that one. I thought it meant something else, like you should tell someone he's there. Not, you should tell, whatever. Alright.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the Flapjack fire, or the site fire, or...?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yeah, this whole end of the game is pretty straightforward. I mean, this game makes you think about trust in people and perception of what's going on and stuff you find. I don't know, I'm rambling. Because I don't know what to.
I think I'm getting close.
Alright, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cutback in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Hmm. Okay, hope I have to repel.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my God, Henry.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for Croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids, all right? Nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want
that's where the trail sign went.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son. You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. He held on to some of Brian's things, his wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
Teen magazines.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site. He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Henry M. I didn't know that. Never. Of supplies, propane, 2,000 ounces of propane, 300 buried, three socks. All right, oxygen.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
I'm sorry. Yeah,
he's a hermit.
I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
This boombox looks familiar.
Oh, it's for that in the lake.
Girls.
Yeah.
I thought you threw it into the lake.
Well, he must have fished it out. He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going.
First Ranger, fly fishing, Tom on the Grizz, Henry. So I started May 1st, 79 days. That's what? Mid August?
He had quite the view. He's got a radio base station up here.
Hey.
He was listening to us on that.
Beer cans. Of course it is. Alright. Time to get out of here. And head back to... What is it? Head to Thoroughfare. So I just gotta go... east and then north. Go that way. That's where I just came from. Aha. Just, yeah. Alright, I go to Jonesy. Jonesy is west, so I gotta go this way. Jonesy Lake, and then go northeast.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. It was
Jonesy.
A sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Lila, I think it was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
Henry, they're here. They're waiting right now.
Please.
Henry, I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that. I know that sounds harsh. Okay, I'll wait.
I'm not far.
Okay.
Here we go, and we run. We gotta go to the supply station, and then we go a little bit north of that. And that's where the tram should be. Thoroughfare, 5 miles. And how is the music? That the, I don't know what this one was. Oh, there's that. That's east, so we go this way. Figure out a way to go this way. There we go. How this goes. Like that? Guess I don't remember at all. And this friggin' smoke ash stuff is not helping. Why did I unlock? Oh, I did unlock it. All right. Follow this. This should go. There we go. And then we say goodbye to the Shoshone. Up there. Oh. West. Clear. There we go. There we go. West. Okay. Right way. And then this should take me. There we go, it just took a little while. Supply cache is right up there. Thoroughfare is right over here. The emergency skyline, whatever it's called.
I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
It seems sketchy. Remember this at all. Don't remember.
Oh god, it's a nightmare out there.
Oh god.
Hello? Delilah.
And she's gone. It was designed to Pork Pond, but now we know who took it. She left her shirt here, and her thousands of crossword puzzles, and her empty bottle of tequila, and another bottle of tequila. Drawing of us. I am Turt. Bunch of maps. Moose thing. Fuzzy slippers. Why does she need chairs? I don't get it.
Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me.
You're not here.
Oh, look, it's the problem.
No. Don't be mad.
I'm not.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
I get it.
Yeah, August, yeah.
You do?
I think so.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe...
I go with the selfish one. Always gotta go with the selfish one.
Maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
Thank you, Delilah. I appreciate it.
I mean it. Good luck.
Thanks.
Bye, Hank.
This is the end of the game. Sitting there, paranoid, thinking that somebody's out to get you, and you think that you're gonna get killed or fired or whatever, but it's just one guy being a hermit in the woods and making your life hell for 79 days. And I'm pretty sure he started that fire. So, the whole basis of the story of the of figuring out what's going on with yourself and... I don't know. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just, this game just makes you think a lot. And it's a great game. This game is over 8 years old. And, oh, they're all in the pictures. I forgot about that. And all this audio is probably going to get copyright strikes. So, great. Alright, we're going to stop that, so I don't get copyright striked, but that was Firewatch. If you have not played it, I suggest you play it. It's a really good game. And I just realized that the opening Firewatch lookout is Delilah's. So... hope everyone enjoyed that. I think that's my longest episode ever. But, I hope you guys, have a good one. Stay civil and see you later. Bye.